Hey there guys, I'm Jesse Crowe, the traveling scientist, and today I want to teach you guys about the science of paracetamol. So paracetamol is a cheap and effective drug that can be used to treat aches and pains, as well as reduce a fever. But how does it actually work? When the cells in your body are damaged, they release arachidonic acid, which gets converted by an enzyme called cyclooxygenase, or COX, into prostaglandins. And prostaglandins have a wide variety of effects, but mainly they cause pain, like the pain you get when you have a headache, and fever, like what you might feel when you've got a really bad cold. But there's a simple solution to this. Take a paracetamol, right? Well, what does that paracetamol actually do? How does it work? Now, I'm going to be completely honest with you here. Nobody in the world actually knows how paracetamol works. I know, right? Ridiculous. I mean, this drug's been on the market for over 60 years. What is this mystery drug that somehow treats pain? Well, let me tell you after over 100 years of research what scientists think paracetamol might be doing. So when you take paracetamol, it probably works to inhibit that COX enzyme. Or, to put it in another way, it COX blocks arachidonic acid, preventing the production of prostaglandins and thereby reducing that pain and fever. Also, the main difference between paracetamol and other pain relief drugs is that paracetamol doesn't have any anti-inflammatory effects, so it's not going to be very effective at treating things like sore muscles or arthritis. So that all kind of makes sense, right? But is paracetamol bad for you? Normally, paracetamol is prescribed and preferred because it causes less adverse effects than other pain relief drugs, such as aspirin or ibuprofen, which are known to damage the gut mucosa and can cause gastrointestinal bleeding. However, a study in 2011 in the UK showed that paracetamol causes just as much gastrointestinal bleeding as ibuprofen, so that's not great. And paracetamol can also mess with your liver and kidneys when the drug is metabolized because it produces a toxic byproduct called NAPQI, or that thing. Now, this usually gets detoxified pretty quickly, but in large amounts, it can seriously damage your liver and kidneys. Don't get me wrong, I'm still going to take paracetamol occasionally if I have like a killer headache, but if you take this drug regularly, then you should see a doctor. Paracetamol is a cheap and effective way to treat pain, but it can have some serious side effects, so be careful. Anyway, that's all for today, guys. I hope you learned something about paracetamol, and I'm sure one day we'll figure out what it's actually doing. I actually studied a lot of pharmacology at university. So if you have any questions at all about medications or drugs, put it in the comment section below or send it to me on my website, and I'll try to make a video about it in the future. Finally, subscribe for more Traveling Scientist every week, and I'll see you guys next time. Cheers. But there's a simple solution. But there's a super...